For today's headlines, let's go over to the CBN News Desk.
Gordon, Egypt's Muslim Brotherhood is calling for a wave of protests today after the military ousted that country's president and other top officials. Some are concerned, though, those protests will turn violent in retaliation for the removal of Mohamed Morsi, and there are still concerns about a civil war. Chris Mitchell has the story.
Millions of Egyptians celebrated the army's takeover in the streets of Cairo on Thursday. They see the army as the protector of the revolution that started 2 years ago.
I am here now because I am so happy for Egypt. My feeling is that I have my country back. We never liked anything done by the Muslim Brotherhood. This is the first time in 50 years that my heart is warmed.
The jubilation comes just 1 year after the Muslim Brotherhood's Morsi was elected president of the country, bringing Islamists to power for the first time. Many felt he betrayed the people and destroyed the economy.
We are standing here victorious. We want to complete our victory by bringing in the people who are going to rule the country. Because, as you know, the ruler of the country was unjust. They even lacked religion, and they wanted to divide us as religious and secular, and they managed to do it.
Some called for calm.
All that I ask of our great people who are supporting the ousted president is to close the gap that is between the Egyptian people. We should all unite and forget about the past.
But Islamists are not backing down, and it looks like trouble could be on the way.
We will be protesting until the return of President Morsi to rule and to be the president again, or we die here as martyrs. This sit-in must not stay just that. We are supposed to bring more crowds, and we should move to more sensitive places, like the Ministry of Defense and to the Supreme Constitutional Court. And if we knew where Morsi is being held, we would go there and release him.
The White House stopped short of calling the overthrow a military coup. A coup would usually trigger economic sanctions and a cut in U.S. aid. In neighboring Israel, officials are not commenting on developments, but are concerned that Islamists could take advantage of any chaos in the country to launch attacks from the Sinai Desert or Gaza Strip into Israel. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
France's President François Hollande has criticized the U.S. electronic surveillance program, but the French newspaper Le Monde reports that a French intelligence agency has also been monitoring phone calls and online activities. A French lawmaker, however, says the program requires an authorization and is legal. Here at home, thousands of communities celebrated the 4th of July with fireworks, but in California, dozens of spectators were injured when the fireworks at their display malfunctioned. Heather Sells has that story.
Thousands were watching this professional display in Simi Valley, an LA suburb, when something terrible happened. A malfunction just 2 minutes into the show sent fireworks into the crowd. Police are still investigating, but say it appears the accident happened when a platform holding the fireworks tipped over. Paramedics took 20 people to the hospital with minor to moderate injuries.
I thought it was pretty spectacular, and then everything just went crazy, and everybody started screaming, and everything that was supposed to happen didn't happen, so it was pretty frightening. And a block of wood about this big came shooting down, and it hit the side of my leg.
We had bits and pieces of fireworks coming at us. A big round cylinder block hit the person sitting next to me.
After the accident, authorities immediately stopped the show and evacuated the field. A bomb squad deactivated the remaining fireworks. Nationally, fireworks safety is a big concern with trauma professionals. They treat 10,000 people a year for fireworks injuries. And ironically, their advice is to go to professional displays rather than risk setting off explosives at home. Heather Sell, CBN News.
Those are today's top stories from CBN News. In the next few days, Muslims around the world will begin their holy month of Ramadan. It's an intense time of prayer and fasting lasting about 30 days. Observers abstain from food, drink, and other pleasures from sunrise to sunset with the goal of purifying the body and focusing the mind on spiritual pursuits. It's also a time, however, when Christians pray for the Islamic world, asking God to reveal to them the truth about Jesus Christ. Operation Blessing is playing a role in the opening of a new important teaching hospital in Haiti. Created by Partners in Health, it will provide primary care to about 185,000 people in the area. Operation Blessing drilled 5 water wells, including the primary hospital well and 2 community wells for public use. OB also brought about the donation of a water disinfectant and filtration system for the hospital. You can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to its website at ob.org.